Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at using TCPDUMP as a packet analyzer from our Linux command line. So working from my SUSE Linux host, I've connected via SSH. We can start looking at the packet analyzer. Now don't be put off from the command line. It is really quite a simple process and very quick compared to some of the graphical tools that we might have. So starting off then with the TCPDUMP command, we specify the interface we want to listen on, so minus I and then ETH 0 and then hit enter. And goodness me, what a lot of traffic we have. Of course, at the moment I am connecting on SSH, so I'm seeing everything that I'm doing and all of the display updates, etc., etc., etc. So of course I wouldn't get this on the console, but sometimes it's not convenient to run the packet captures from the console. So the simplest thing that we could do would be to limit the amount of packets to capture. So if I do a minus C2, we're only going to capture 2 packets, but it's still not really solving my problem because I'm still flooded by all of this SSH traffic. But it's a simple example where we only want to capture a certain amount of traffic on the network. So the reality is we need to start looking at adding in filters. So I can leave the count in if I want, but then if I start specifying filters, we can specify exactly what ports or perhaps which ports we don't want. Well, we can see that we don't want port 22, so I can just go not port 22. So we still captured our 2 packets, but this time we can see that yes, they are not SSH traffic on port 22. So clearing the screen and then up arrowing, I can go back and change, of course, my query. So I might take the count out for the moment. And then going back looking at my filter, rather than saying not port 22, we might say only look for IP6 traffic. So here I could put TCP, UDP, IP, IP6, ARP, those sorts of things. But we can see we have a little bit of IP version 6 traffic. Again, it might be useful to try and work out, well, what traffic do you have on the network? But of course, when I say on the network, we are actually talking at the moment to and from this machine, the console that I've logged onto, the IP machine .70. If we want to set the network card into promiscuous mode, we could possibly listen for traffic destined for any host on the network. A lot really just depends on the configuration of our network. It used to be much easier where we have hubs, but very often where we have switches on the network, we might not have any traffic directed through to our ports in any case for the network card to listen. So if I run an IP link show for ETH0, I can see the normal options broadcast and multicast. If I do an IP link set and then ETH0 promisc on, we're turning on promiscuous mode. So if there is traffic coming through my port on the switch, I'll be able to pick that up, whether it's destined for my network card or not. Now this is turning it on now, but if we need this permanently turned on, we would set it in the network configuration. Using SUSE, the network configuration is going to be in the etc sysconfig network directory. If you are using Red Hat, Fedora, Ubuntu, very often they are located in the networking scripts directory in sysconfig. But either way, the configuration file is going to be very similar. And then we just need to add the option promisc equals yes. So with that said, now if the network card reboots, we are going to set it into promiscuous mode so it can actually listen to all traffic on the network. Now this server was used last time for the NFS server, so I could then go through and change my filter to look for now source coming from my NFS client. So I've added in the option SRC 192.168.0.0. 71, and the port is 111, the RPC port that we're going to listen on to initiate our NFS connections. If I go to my client machine and then specify to issue the show mount minus E, I should be able to see the RPC connection coming in to my machine. So there we go. One of the things though we might notice is that we're seeing the port service names, not the numbers. So we can see we've captured port 111, but that's being represented by Sun RPC. So if I wanted to change that, so change a TCP dump command to show me the port numbers rather than the names, then it's quite a simple matter to put the option into TCPDUMP minus NN, the double N. A single N would only work for not running the reverse lookup for the DNS names, so it would show me IP addresses rather than DNS names. I don't have any DNS names to resolve. But the double N would show me both the IP addresses of the host, not the DNS names, and the port numbers, not the port names. So running through the commands again, we can now see that we're coming in from the client port 797 and connecting in then to the server port on 111. A little bit more practical, if I jump out to my working server, a radio server, and then we start looking at UDP port 1812. So again, you can see we're looking for UDP port and port 1812. So we're looking at the radius traffic. If we're trying to debug some connectivity issues, we might now try to log on from the client and actually see, well, is the radius traffic actually getting through to the radius server? And what is the response coming from the radius server? So as I log on to my client, let's first of all log on with an incorrect password. So we can see we've got the radius access request and then the access is being rejected by our server. So let's try the same procedure again, but this time putting in the correct password. So we can see the incoming traffic, the request, and then the outgoing traffic from this machine to the authentication gateway is now the accept. So let's control C out of this and run a little further test. If we put minus capital A into the TCP dump, we're going to need to capture ASCII data and display it on the screen. This might help us debug a little bit further as to what is actually happening. So as I log on to the client, we can now see the ASCII data that's included in the packets. So I actually see here the username Joe. So again, we can actually verify the username that is being passed through. The password is going to be in here as well, but I'm not going to be able to decode the password. But again, we've got the request and the accept, so we know from this side of things the radius server is doing its job. So then it's a matter of interrogating a little bit more if something was going wrong. But we've proved the radius server is authenticating our user. So as with any packet capture, these sorts of things can become totally invaluable because all you know is that things aren't working on the network. Now we can try and decode what's happening. So we started off looking at the simple TCP dump and soon realized that we're going to have to filter some packets. So we then chose to not include port 22. And then we're looking at other filters that could include different protocols and different ports. So we're looking at IP6, we were looking at UDP and port 1812. We're looking at setting the card into promiscuous mode, so it's not a function of the packet capture, it's more a function of the networking side of things. So we set our network card into promiscuous mode. So we're able to see packets that are across the entire network dependent on our hub or switch infrastructure. But I certainly hope you found this useful.